everybody, and welcome to another episode of Between Two Warships. This is Tanks for the Mammeries, playing World of Warships, and this is the series where we sit with a personality from the community, World of Warships, to discuss the current state of the game, and play a few rounds while we chat. Tonight, we're very fortunate to have Critter, one of the founders of ShipComrade.com, otherwise known as Bill, and Bill is here with us to talk about ShipComrade.com. We're going to get a little background on him. If you don't know what ShipComrade.com is, you guys got to go check it out. If you're playing World of Warships, it is an outstanding fan site. He gets cooperation from the World of Warships folks. He's got community contributors. He gets all the videos posted up there. He breaks out all of the stuff from the developers that come on the forums. Really great site. Has all the ship trees and all the tech specs for the ships and everything in there, including ships you haven't seen yet. So do check that out. I'm super pleased to have him here tonight. As of October 1st, he had over 200,000 views on ShipComrade.com. It's not even 3 months old. I'd love to take credit for it because I'm always plugging him on my videos, but frankly, it's all his hard work that he's done. He's basically doing it by himself. A little bit of help from Ivan and some other people that we'll talk about later, but essentially, it is a one-man show. So do check it out. It's a great site. Welcome, Critter. Thanks for taking time out of your schedule to come on with us tonight and have a chat, a few games. Really excited to have you here. So why don't you say hi to everybody out there, and we'll go ahead and get started.
Hello, everybody. The site itself, though, it's not just me, though. This community is just excellent. I've never seen a community like the World of Warships community. And if it wasn't for the contributors and wargaming and people like yourself, ShipComrade would be nothing. And so I definitely give a big shout-out to you guys. The site's a little less than 3 months old. I originally started it because, I mean, I've always been a wargaming fan, and I was playing World of War Tanks back in 2012 all the way up until I finally got into closed beta with World of Warships and was hooked. From that point, though, I got into, seeing what the developers were saying about the game. Where were they going? And so I spent a lot of time on their forums. I used to play a game called, everybody should be familiar with it, World of Warcraft. I played it for 10 years, and I used to follow a dev tracker on a website. I used to be visited every day, and I was like, well, you know, love to have something like that for this community.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
But the problem is Wargaming is a multi-division company. It's not like World of Warcraft.
That's right.
They got one office, one forum. World of Warships got four of them.
Yeah.
So I was thinking, well, how could I create a dev tracker that would, you know, get us the information we need?
Mm-hmm.
I also used to follow a site called FTR, For the Record.
Yep.
And they used to, monitor all the Russian posts. It was like, well, why don't I make a dev tracker that integrates Google Translate so we can see what they're saying over there?
Mm-hmm.
And we can see what's going on in the other division. So I went to work on it.
Well, before we get too far into that, let's go ahead and get into a game, and then we'll keep talking.
Okay.
What I want to do, folks, is let you guys know that Bill's going to be playing some of the Russian destroyers tonight, and if we have time, maybe even some of the German cruisers. But right now, we're going to play the Tier 3. He's got the Derzki, and I'm going to be playing the St. Louis. So let's just jump into the match, and let's back up a little bit, Bill, and just let me talk a little bit about your background. You know, sort of, you say you started playing World of Warships. Before that, you were playing World of Warcraft. Any military background at all, or just love the history and that sort of thing?
Yeah, first Gulf War. I served 90 through 97.
Okay.
I didn't get any frontline action, but, I served.
Gotcha.
I got out in 97, and actually went into electrical work, and then a couple years later I got into computer work, and I've been doing it ever since.
Cool. Well, it certainly shows, I think, the quality of the site, and what you've been able to accomplish in such a short period of time. It certainly shows.
So, yeah, it's definitely going pretty well, I think.
We'll go back and talk about because you're absolutely right. I mean, you've got the Russian sites, you've got the European, you've got the U.S., you've got Southeast Asia, and trying to coordinate all of those different bits of information from all those different community folks has got to be tough. So do talk about that a little bit. I think it's pretty interesting for folks to find out.
Yeah, it is, because a lot of them have their own marketing plans. So the communication link, I mean, look at NA. When I first came onto the scene and on NA and closed beta, there really wasn't any information coming out of NA. None at all.
Yeah.
You had to pretty much go to EU to get some.
Yep.
And it was like, well, what about, you know, what about the English-speaking community? Why does everybody need to run to EU?
Yeah.
So I started trying to make contact with Wargaming NA, and I was lucky enough to actually get their attention, thank God. Gunline ended up leaving.
Yep.
And my ex came in, WGA. She came in onto the scene. She's actually the head of Wargaming NA, not just World of Warships. She stepped in while they were recruiting a new CM, and she has just been fantastic. She has completely changed the entire NA community.
I know why, but tell people, because there are a lot of folks here that watch this probably don't go onto the forums, as much as I encourage them to do so, and actually encourage them probably to use your site, I think is a bit better. I just got detected. It's probably better to use your site because it tends to condense things down a bit more. Mm-hmm. But, you know, why do you think it is that what's made her so beneficial to the community and so successful so far?
To be honest, I'm not sure why. I don't know if the previous staff just didn't have the power to do the changes that were necessary. She did. I really don't, and I'm just speculating by saying so.
Right, okay. But she does seem to answer, you know, she does seem to be able to answer people fairly quickly. I haven't hit this guy for shit yet. Maybe that'll work. He's hauling that Wix around, isn't he? Okay. So, while we're trying not to die here, why don't you talk a little bit about some of the different features you have on your site? Because we mentioned Red Tracker and things like that. But you've got, you know, you've got the ship trees, and you've got Red Tracker. Which, why don't you talk about that a little bit for folks who aren't sure what it is? You still with me?
Oh boy, I just ate some torpedoes.
Okay. Alright, he's dead. So.
Double suicide. I got him, he got me.
Okay. So, well, talk a little bit about some of the features.
I mean, besides the Red Tracker, which is a really handy thing, I think that is probably the main thing that draws people to the site. The Ship Tree Video Library. Basically, it's a spot that we have currently hooked into Wargaming's API. We're pulling in basically the detailed stats. We're still improving that. I'm still working on that constantly. We just finally got the module trees dynamic out of their database. The plan is hopefully this weekend to make them clickable and make them actually reflect the changes into the stats.
Really?
Yeah.
That'd be very almost interactive. That's very cool.
Yeah, exactly. That's the plan. I'm trying to make it work exactly like it does in the game, but with no mouse over, so you can use it on a tablet or a phone.
Oh, that'd be very cool.
And then after that, the next step would be adding the upgrades. But the thought process behind the ship tree is, you know, you can go someplace, look at a screenshot, check out the detailed stats, you know, modify the ship whatever way you want. But also, it's hooked into the forums that are related to that ship or that ship tree. And there's all the videos that are from all the contributors. So you can go there and actually check out, you know, actual gameplay of that ship before you decide to invest your time or money into trying to go down that line.
Right. All stations, I require immediate assistance.
I mean, these contributor videos are just, I mean, I use it. That's how I learn.
Yeah.
I mean, between the guides and there's just so much information.
That's exactly what I do. I go see who's whether it's Fly or Baron or, you know, Chase, somebody who's playing something and say, okay, maybe that's my style. But to be able to look at it that way directly from your site is going to be really cool. So you're going to start working on that on this weekend?
To make the modules clickable. The modules are dynamic now. Hopefully I can get it done by the end of the weekend. If not, it'll be next weekend. It was a little tricky getting the module trees done. Trying to build that dynamically out of a database took a little longer than I thought. So now that that's done, though,
Very
I can
cool.
make them clickable. Because I got the data behind it. I just got to do it.
Very cool. So I know that Wargaming's been really been very supportive of you. So did you approach them with this idea that you were going to do this, or did you just start doing it and then, you know, they were like, hey, we like what you got going on?
Oh, I was working on this thing for almost for a solid 3 months before I finally approached them. I was going to do it with it without them. I mean, I wanted the information. I figured everybody else did too.
Yeah.
But they just, you know, they decided initially they weren't going to work with me. Gunlion did not want to work with me at all, pretty much.
Huh. All right, I'm trying to pound the St. Louis.
But the same thing also happened with Hector and EU. But now he's awesome. I mean, the work he's doing, everything's kind of changed over there too, recently in the last month or so.
Do you think it is?
Well, a lot of staff is being rearranged right now, and I think there's still a shortage on staff.
I cannot catch this guy on fire.
It's not these guys' fault. They're doing, I mean, they're slammed. They are purely slammed. I mean, their PM boxes on the forums are just constantly filled. They're trying to keep the community happy at the same time.
Yeah. Sorry, I'm trying not to die here. Oh, man. All right, I got killed. I got dead. All right.
Yeah, it didn't work out the way I was hoping.
So what other new features are you going to be adding in the future here to the website?
I definitely want to upgrade the red tracker. I want it to be more in-depth, actually show the original post, show the complete response.
That'd be cool. All right, I'm going to go back to port. No sense in just sitting around on that.
But upgrade modules, too. Not upgrade, but what's the word I'm looking for?
You mean like the
yeah,
going from stock to the like the next level, or are you talking about the actual modules, like not the consumables and stuff, but like the main battery modifications and things like the upgrades?
Yeah, the upgrades.
Okay.
And I actually have that reflect into the stats too.
Hey, have you know what would be interesting, and I meant to talk to you about this before. Have you ever seen the chart that I had? I posted it on one of my videos that was talking about how to do upgrades and things on your ships. And there was a chart that had been done, and I gave the guy credit in the video. I can't remember who he is now, but whoever you were, thank you very much for that. That talked about the different skills that you should get for your captains based on the ships and the tiers.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
You know, there's some things like that out there that I, you know, and I'll shoot you that, because, you know, there's a lot of people that are like, oh, I should just get my captain this skill or this skill. They don't really think about it, and then they move them to a different ship where that skill may not be of any value, or they just don't know sort of what you should have on your ship for either modifications or upgrades or whatever. So I think something like that would be a really helpful sort of chart to say, if you're doing American destroyers, then maybe these are the skills you should get for your captains and what the ship should have on them. That might be kind of cool.
That definitely would be. There's already a few contributor videos for just that.
Yep.
But they're not, I don't think they're actually line specific.
Yeah, I would agree. I mean, I think Chase says, here's what I would do in some of his. But I'll, you know what I'll do when we're done with this? I'll send you that chart. I've got that chart.
Okay. Sounds good.
That's pretty cool. Did we win that? Yeah, we did.
Wow.
Yeah. All right, what level? Okay, you're going to do 4, so I will do...
Yeah, the thing that's nice about these Russian ships, which I have not been able to show yet, is, I mean, they have really short torpedo range, but they have a really narrow hull. So it really makes their detectability range really small.
Right. Well, I'm going to run with you on this one. They're probably going to pop us on different sides of the map, but I'm going to get, I'll come run to where you are. So, you obviously put a lot of time in the into Ship Comrade. Do you enjoy that as much as you do the game, you know, or is it taking time away from you playing?
It does take, definitely hurts my gaming. I mean, anybody that looks me up on the forums will see I only did like 41 matches, but unfortunately, that's because I've been over on my press account.
Right.
It's hard not to play on it.
Yeah, when you get the ships, sure. By the way, folks, that's what we're playing right now. Bill's on his press account, so that's why we have access to the Russian ships here. So what I'm going to try and do, everybody, is get over there so you can see the Izyazlav. What did I say it was called? Izyazlav?
I cannot do the Russian pronunciation of it.
Izyazlav. Yeah, Izyazlav.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Izyazlav.
There you go. You even got the accent.
So we're going to go to, we're going to head over here to get a quick peek at this ship. And then I'll follow you in, man. We'll go wherever you want to head. But there we go. This is the Tier 4 Russian destroyer Izyazlav. And how many torpedo tubes does that one have?
It's like 3 mounts with triples.
Ah, nice. And is it pretty fast?
I've yet to get it up to speed here.
Gotcha. So, as you had mentioned before, this is not, as much as, you know, I keep saying it's a one-man show, I realize that you've got some other folks. Is there anybody out there, you'd especially like to give a shout-out to that... of the community contributors or your site contributors that deserve a special shout out right now?
Well, definitely Ivan. Ivan's been with me. Ivan 56, I think he is. He is our historical writer and editor contributor for the for Ship Comrade. He has just been phenomenal.
Yeah, guys, if you have, like I said, go check out Ship Comrade. But if you haven't gone and looked at some of the information that Ivan's put in there about some of the different ships, you should really take a look at that because he is a really good writer. He's got really interesting stories on some of the different ships in the game, and it's well worth taking a look at. That's a Clemson.
But we also have Top Dog and... there's actually quite a few volunteers with the site, and we have our new community manager.
Yeah, so you guys are, I was really impressed with how many people sort of joined in to post things, but I know you're also pulling videos from folks out there, so. But Ivan's, his writing was really good. He caught me right off the bat on a couple of things, and I spent, you know, probably an hour longer than I should have reading during a work day some of his stuff. Boss, if you're listening, apologies.
Yeah, they're really good. We're so lucky to have him.
Yeah. No, he's good. All right. Whoops.
Sorry, I'm kind of trying to concentrate with this destroyer.
No, you're all right. I'm doing the same thing over here.
actually my first time playing this ship too.
Yeah, I've got a Phoenix. Oh, shit. Oh, I'm gonna get smoked. God damn it. Yeah. Shit. I'm not gonna be able to torpedo that fucking guy. Nope. Alright, we're gonna go follow you.
Oh boy.
That's a lot of torpedoes, Jesus. I don't think he's gonna be able to outrun that. There you go, good job. So we talked about you playing World of Warcraft in the past and World of Tanks. I'm assuming between your job and the website and World of Warships, there's not much else you're playing right now, but what do you play? You play anything else?
Currently, no. Yeah. I'm pretty much full focused on World of Warships. I want to see this title succeed.
That is a long, skinny ship. I'm just giving everybody a view of it here. They did a good job with it. What's the torpedo reload on that?
Cannot tell right now.
Okay. So is this the first time you've played this ship?
Yeah, this first time this one, too.
Okay.
Yeah. Just got these ships last Friday. There's 10 of them.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, that guy's toast. How many of the German ships have you played?
Like three of them, I think.
Impressions?
Can't really give one. I'm really not a cruiser player. I either play destroyers or BBs.
That guy's gonna be dead before you get there. Oh, he's just sitting there.
And unfortunately, I'm still under NDA, so I can't really give opinions on any of them.
Okay.
I like my relationship with Wargaming. I want to keep it that way.
Fair enough. No worries. We can let that go. They'll be out there for everybody to mess with. What, in about 10 days?
Yeah, 19th.
Yeah. So coming up, folks. But you do get to see some of the lower tier Russian destroyers here tonight. How's the gun turning speed on that one?
Not too bad. I mean, not extremely fast. It's no sims, that's for sure.
We got a cap. All right, good. So, you'd mentioned that you are really excited about things like the clans coming and some of the other stuff that's going to be coming into the game in the future. What concerns do you have that you think may not be addressed yet, or stuff that you've heard they are going to do or that they said they're not going to do? Is there anything out there that gives you pause?
Not currently, no. They still need to do something about border riding. That's a problem.
Yeah.
But they've been listening to the community, in my opinion. I kind of wish they would prioritize clans. Right now, clans is needed bad in this game. It's okay for people like myself, workers. I have coworkers I play with. 1 second, end a fight here.
Yep.
So I play every night with people I know, but people that don't have, real life people they play with, they're gonna grow bored without a community to play with.
Mm-hmm.
And clans is kind of really needed, in my opinion, and it should be prioritized. Now, they did say it should happen this year, but I still think it needs to happen faster. Clans are what keeps people coming back. It's friends to play with.
Yep. What do you think about some of the new game modes that are rumored to be out there?
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear that over the game sound. Say that again.
I was going to say, what do you think about some of the game modes that are rumored to be out there?
I believe they are coming out with a team battle. That hopefully that's related to the Clan Wars kind of thing. I mean, it won't be Clan Wars, but it'll still be battles that clans can do together.
Mm-hmm.
I really haven't heard much more about anything else coming up besides the rank match. You know, we have the rank matches and the improvements to the rank matches that they're going to be doing. They're going to be adding more tiers to it.
Yeah, I've found that a bit frustrating. Because I think with people who don't have that many games under their belt, that ranked matches necessarily, let me put it this way. I think if people are not as experienced in playing the game, you're going to bounce back and forth between going up and going down. Because people have not got a... I'm not saying this right. I know what I want to say, I just don't have the words. People are not very consistent in the quality of their gameplay yet because they're not very experienced. And I think that that's what I've seen with ranked battles is I'll win one, lose one, win one, lose one, and I'm not seeing a lot of people moving up the food chain.
Right. I don't know. I mean, I have limited play in the ranked. But the tiers seem to be coming pretty quick, and I'm sure once you get into that next bracket, then you won't be with the newbies anymore. Yeah,
well,
game time lower. Waiting for a game is going to be longer, but
yeah. But I mean, even because the original, you know, what was it, the beta version testing of that was tier 7 and 8 or something like that, 6, 7, and 8. so you should theoretically have people who, if they've gotten that far, are consistently pretty good. But
yeah,
it didn't seem to work out that way. I don't know.
It's still young.
Yeah, that's
I'm
true.
Sure
that's
they'll
true.
Modify it.
That's true.
They'll continually improve it, just like I'll continually to improve ShipComrade.
All right, so you're the boss of Wargaming for one day. What are you going to do? What's the one thing you'd implement?
Get clans in immediately. I mean, I've already said that, but... set up better communication channels between the divisions. That'd be a big one.
Yeah.
I've been trying to help with that. I hope it has gotten better. But could it be even better? Yes.
Absolutely. Well, you know, what do you make of this whole putting premium vehicles in packages as opposed to just selling them individually. I'm kind of getting tired of that.
Yeah, it's a marketing thing. Yeah. I mean, they get a huge investment into this game, and it's just released, so they need to recoup some of it to keep going. That's all I can say.
But they're even doing it with World of Tanks, you know. They keep re-releasing what they call rare vehicles or whatever, but they're putting them into packages. And, you know, they're not doing it in countries that don't quite have the income that they expect of us here. And I know they do lots of marketing, you know, studies and things like that, and they've got all that information, but it just seems like, you know, they figure, well, the Americans are rich and they can afford to pay $50 for this or $60 for that. And in the Russian website, they don't. You get the ship for $19 or whatever, and that's that. And I, you know, I'd like to be able to get some things without having a full package. I don't know. That's one of my peeves. I'd say, you know. Were those your torpedoes that hit him?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Trying to finish him off.
It looks like he's still flooding. Yeah, he's dead. Let's see here. What else have I got for you? All right, without busting your NDA, anything good that you're aware of that's coming out that you can talk about?
They're kind of tight-lipped right now.
Yeah.
Not really. I mean, I do know clans are coming, team battles. To that, I really don't know. I mean, when you compare it to World of Tanks, you can kind of imagine what's coming. It's the same company. You know they're going to follow the same model.
Yeah. I was surprised that we were getting Russian ships and German ships at the same time. I mean, I figured Russian would be coming pretty quick just because it's such a huge market for them. But I was surprised about the Germans before the British. I thought that was really surprising.
Yeah,
I thought that was happening, but I think you got him. You're going to put a couple of hits on him anyway.
Yeah.
How many? Oop, maybe not.
No, that other one's AFK over there, so... Yeah, a couple hits.
I can't believe that Wyoming's been sitting there the whole time, AFK.
Yeah, totally AFK. It's kind of sad.
Yep. That's a bummer.
He's just on fire, burning away. Get the marshmallows.
And a St. Louis is probably not going to survive that destroyer down there, the Izyazlav. Oh, well. All right. I'm going to garage it so we can do one more. You cool with that?
Sounds good.
Port it, not garage it. Whatever. Wrong game.
I also need to give a huge shout-out to the streamers. OGZM, Primrose, Braincage, DJ Knights. I mean, there's so many good streamers. Mm-hmm. It's perfect, too, because when they come to the site, let's say a new player shows up at ShipComrade, you got video guides, and you got live streamers where you can just jump in and watch people play the game and ask questions.
That's a good point. Yeah, it's a very good point. One thing, I have been doing some Twitch streaming. I just haven't been making videos out of them.
These guys love... It's not so much about the videos, though. They love helping others in the community, and especially love growing this community.
Yep.
I mean, this community is a slightly more mature crowd because of the pace of the game. At least that's my opinion.
I agree with that.
And it tends to make the community a lot more mature.
Yeah, I would agree with that. I do think it is I would like to see some of the socioeconomic stats on this community down the road someday, because I do think we are older player base. I would tend to agree with that, because the pace of the game is slower. And it's much more strategic, I think, You got to think
definitely.
Way ahead.
Yeah.
Well, why don't you pick a higher tier ship and I'll match. We'll do our last match in higher tier.
Now, what tier are you thinking?
We can do 6, 7. I'll take the Sims.
Sims? Okay.
Let me see.
Let me see if I can find the German cruiser at 7 here. I haven't set it up yet, but at least I don't think I have.
Or I can do the Atlanta. If you're gonna do a German cruiser, I'll do the Atlanta.
Okay.
That'd be cool.
Actually, this is already set up. All right. Yorck.
Oh, awesome. All right, folks, this is going to be fun. We're gonna see the Tier 7 German cruiser Yorck, and I'll probably crash into him 3 or 4 times, just admiring. We'll get an up-close look at it. Have you played this one yet? If it's set up, you may have done that earlier for us. But
I think I have played this one. Again, I can't give an opinion on it, but the problem is when I'm playing these ships that are unreleased, I tend to get focus fired by the entire other side,
right?
And tend to die pretty quick, which just kills my stats.
Well, the good news is there's no carriers in this fight, and it is a tier 7 match, so that's good. I'm pleased with that. Do you on your regular account? Do you use any mods?
Actually, I don't run mods of any type.
Okay. I do use some of the stuff from Azlane.
Yeah, that's a very good mod pack. I kind of like it realistic. I've seen some of these things that the mods enable, and it looks like Star Wars is going on.
I don't like that.
It's a little bit more realistic without mods, in my opinion. But there's some mods that actually add to that. I just haven't played with them.
Yeah, my zoom reticle mod is so much better than the one that came with the game. It's been very helpful to me. Yeah, we are going to see all the Grimmies on one side. I bet they're going to be on the side you're on. I'm going to do AP on those fuckers, too. That is a pretty ship. Look at that. So somebody's asking you how your Yorck plays.
Yeah, that usually happens. Unfortunately, I can't answer. But if they want to see this, there might be a video up there. Up on the site. I know the stats, some shots on module trees are up there, so. Otherwise, you'll get to find out the 19th.
Well, I will. Oh, there's a Grimmy. Yep. All right. Those are going to be two.
Turret rotation is kind of slow on this. Where'd that DD go?
I don't know. He was heading westbound. But I don't even see his smoke knuckles anymore in there.
There's his torps. Watch out.
Yep. Widespread, narrow spread.
I'm going to try to turn this thing around.
I think he went behind the island.
not quite ready to go through that channel yet.
No, I agree. Our Farragut's over there, Farragut and Cleveland haven't found anybody, so that's good news.
I think that's the... Where's wow, they got five destroyers on that side.
They got five Grimmies, yeah. That means some big guns on that side.
All right, I think there's enough of us. We probably should push through.
Yeah, I'm spinning back around now. Sorry, Nicholas. Apologize for running you off the road. I've been spotted, so. That's what I wanted right there.
Wow.
That shell hit my antenna and damaged a gun turret. I'm not having a whole lot of... Oh, look, shooting that. Ooh, that was fucking close. What's the range of torpedoes on that?
Yeah, I'm dead meat.
All right.
What happened to that battleship that was with us?
He hung back. He hung back. He didn't come any further up. And it looks
we
like
we needed to push together there.
Yeah. Yeah, the destroyer held back too. Now here come the Cleveland, though. The Cleveland and the Damn, this is painful. know how much.
Yeah. For those that might be watching, I have this press account not because I'm a pro, but because I share the information out of the game with you guys. So, I'm definitely no pro. I'm an average player.
Yeah, I'm just trying to hide back here for a second. I think that New Mexico is the only chance I've got. So let me try and kill him. Is he looking at me? Not yet.
The enemy is about to win.
Oh boy.
Got him off.
Now, seeing we've had a lot of short games, why don't we run a regular ship instead so I can actually not get focus fired?
Okay. All right. We can do one more. So is there anything, why don't I just open the floor up to you to, if there's anything you want to say, any rant you want to make, any, whatever, man, I'll open the floor up to you on this one.
Really don't have any rants. It's been a great ride. And it's getting better every day.
Yeah.
I mean, personally, one day, hopefully, I can do this full time. That's the hope. But we got to keep growing this game, and we got to keep growing this community.
Yeah, I agree. As we talked about offline, guys, before y'all got here, it'd be really nice to try and do the newscast once a week. Maybe on a Sunday or something, do a full on newscast so that we catch up on all the week's events and feature some of the streamers. Some of the folks off Twitch, folks that are doing contests, whether it's a wargaming contest or one of the streamers or a YouTuber doing a contest, we can get that information out there to you guys as broadly as possible. So, I'll keep talking to Ship Comrade about that and see if we can't, Bill and I can't make something happen. Why don't you go ahead and pick a ship and I'll follow you here on this.
I'm going to have to take my favorite, which is the Puso.
All right.
I love this ship.
Let me see what I can do. If you're going to do that, I think I'm going to do the Warspite. Let's do this thing.
All right.
You know what? Let's put a few flags on just for fun.
Oh, I also probably should I need to throw a shout out to the EU streamers too. They've been really supportive of the site and bringing the EU community in. People like Delaret, Iril Gray. There's a whole group over there. The Coffee Lounge is a really good group. Especially if you happen to like listen to people's streams during the day when you're at work.
Yeah.
At least for the NA guys. These guys are always on, usually during those periods of time, and they're a riot.
That's cool. I should probably do more of that myself. I probably ought to listen to those guys. That's nice to know. When we're done with this, I'm going to get the link information from you for that.
Okay.
And I'll put that on this video. That'd be cool. Oh, look at us.
Hey.
Yeah, of course you're on the other side.
Not seen any carriers either.
Nope.
Yeah, carriers have definitely dropped on since the last major patch.
Which I'm okay with.
Yeah, manual drops was kind of getting on my nerves a little bit, but, it is part of the gameplay. They'll tweak it, and it'll be fun. We'll start seeing them again.
Yeah, what I really would like them to do is tweak the chance of fire from HE.
Yeah.
It's killing me.
Well, you're getting BBs running with fire HE now, and the fire chance on those big, huge shells is astronomical.
Yeah, especially for the Japanese, it's like 35%.
Yeah.
And that means out of every broadside, you're likely to set fire to somebody. And it's very frustrating. I would like them to fix that. I mean, I understand HE, it ought to be damaging things, but my ship is not made of fucking pine tar kindling. My deck is not, swabbed with gasoline and fucking turpentine.
Well, in most cases, it is wood, though.
Yeah, but Jesus, still.
I know.
I mean, I don't mind them blowing shit up, losing anti-aircraft guns and secondaries and stuff like that, but and even blowing up the airplane. If you haven't launched your plane and you're taking shell fire, it ought to kill your airplane. I'm cool with that, but just getting lit on fire every other shot is just frustrating. That's my rant.
Yeah, I could probably see some adjustments to the fire chance on some of those shells. Especially the ones that pretty much you can almost chain fire.
Yeah. There's a Congo. Can I hit that fucking guy? Oh, I can hit that guy. Hello, Mr. Cleveland. Oh, he's not moving. Wow. The Cleveland is just sitting there in the gap. The Omaha's gonna die, though. Reload, please. Put my plane up. Fuck it. There we go. Oh, shit. Ooh, that was safe. Guy's not moving either. That's amazing. Oh, now he is. Hit him. I'll take that. How you doing over there?
Not too good.
should be on the money. A little long. There we go. Oh shit, that's a destroyer right there. Jesus Christ. So you're down in Florida, is that right?
Say that again?
You're down in Florida?
Yeah, I'm over on the east, central east coast of Florida, the Space Coast, right by the... I actually watched the shuttle and the rockets go up in my backyard.
Nice. That's very cool. Can I shoot this guy yet? This is bad. Can't put my plane back up yet. I'd really like to. There we go. There we go. Good hits. That's nice. Up. Hit him, hit him, hit him. Not enough. That's a Congo back there. That's not fun. It's just you and me, brother.
Right.
It's you and me. At least that fucking destroyer's dead.
Yeah.
I'm
sitting on 4 kills right now.
That really hurt. I've got 0 kills. But I've done 47,000 damage. It's just not great. Just not doing great here. I should be able to hit this guy really, really hard. Oh my God.
Yeah.
dude, that just blows. Oh, you motherfucker, you put my turret back out again, the same one. That is some bullshit. Yeah, I'm going to burn out here, I think. Nothing I can do about it.
Yeah. I got them coming from all directions.
Yeah. Yeah, again, there's the fire. You know, there's nothing I can do about it. Just tough stuff. 60,000 damage.
I'm gonna go down fighting.
Yep. We're watching it. Oop.
Oh, it's over.
You're gonna take one. That's not gonna kill you, but it's gonna hurt. Have you got any repair left? He's gonna torp. He's going to torpedo again. Oh, he missed. He choked. Nah, I got you with that bunch.
well.
All right. Well, at least we got another battle in there. So we got a couple of guys. Just a long video. But I wanted you guys to be able to see some of these ships, and that was fun.
Actually. Carried on that one.
Yeah, how bad was it?
Wow, 6 kills.
Well done. I did better than I thought. Obviously not as good as you, but better than I thought.
Yeah, at least I have one good game.
I'll edit this so you look beautiful. Well.
That was a lot of fun.
That was good stuff. No, listen, man, I appreciate it. Listen, everybody, as I said, Bill is the creator of ShipComrade.com. I really appreciate his time this evening. He was kind enough to take us out in a couple of Russian destroyers that you're going to be able to see on the 19th of October, as well as one of the German cruisers, the Yorck, which you will also be able to see on October 19th. Save up your free XP to work your way up the line of both the Russian and German ships as they come out. Do check out ShipComrade.com. Do give them some support. Again, you can see all the streamers as well as the different YouTubers. Check out the forums. He has all the developers posts separated out of the forum so that you can read those individually. Great site. It's got interactive information on all the different ships, their modules, all that sort of stuff. Bill, thank you so much for your time, man. I really appreciate it. And you know, as we go back and forth, you put my videos up there. I try to give you all the support I can, because I think it's a great site what you're doing. Shout out to Ivan and all the other guys you have working with you there, all the volunteers that pitch in and do stuff for your community. I'll let you have the last word, man. Go ahead. We're wrapping it up, so say whatever you want to say.
Again, much thanks to the volunteers, the community, the contributors, everybody.
Absolutely.
I mean, again, without all you, the site wouldn't exist.
Yep. Good point. So check him out, guys. Again, this is Tanks for the Mammeries, and we are doing Between Two Warships. I appreciate it. It's a long video, but I hope there's some good information in here, and I hope you guys enjoy the games of us getting smoked pretty much, except for the very end there where Bill shows us what his Japanese battleships can do. Thanks very much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and we will catch you guys on the next one. Have a great night, everybody.